Chairman, when do we hold them accountable for perjury or evading taxes?
A lot, evading taxes, many financial crimes. The reason that this has taken so long, in addition to the obstruction for the White House, is there's more evidence that comes in every day.
Is there? Is there, Chairman Comer? Now, that was a House Oversight Committee Chair James Comer, a Republican, who has spearheaded a disastrous and failed attempt at impeaching President Joe Biden. The impeachment inquiry and the investigation into the Bidens has not yielded the evidence that he was hoping for. And so he's claiming that he's basically gonna drop it now because there's just too much evidence.
That's what investigators do all the time. They're like, you know what? There's just too much evidence. Let's just forget about it. Okay, this is a lot of work. I mean, what are we gonna go through all this work? Brother, you've had like 280 meetings and briefings and hearings and all these things. And now at the end, now that you've accumulated that mountain of evidence, you're just gonna let it go? Okay, who can believe this? Who can believe this? And did you notice that all the charges he said, like perjury, avoiding taxes, financial fraud? Oh, right, those are a lot of the same charges that when Trump was charged with it, they were like, you can't charge anybody for that. Those are so minor. Yeah. Those are so minor. And he's like, Biden, all those minor charges, we got a lot of them. I mean, we're not going to show you the evidence of any of them, of course.
No, this is hilarious because of how embarrassing this whole debacle has been for Comer. But it's also kind of depressing because Congress was already increasingly useless in terms of legislating and getting anything done. Now we've entered the era of politically motivated investigations. I get that there was a lot of it earlier, but I think it's intensified, right? There was Hillary Clinton with the endless Benghazi investigations. And I feel like since then, the situation has only gotten worse. Now, it's important that Newsmax's Eric Bolling was grilling Comer about this, and we'll get to that in just a second. But first, it's also important to bring up a recent CNN report that revealed how Comer really thinks the investigation is going. So you hear what he said there, there's so much evidence, and that's why we're gonna like drop it. But during this CNN reporting, here's what we learned. Comer recently approached one of his Republican colleagues and made a blunt admission. He was ready to be done with the impeachment inquiry into Biden, according to the lawmaker who relayed the conversation to CNN. Some in the House GOP, granted the anonymity to speak freely, said they felt Comer often overpromised and underdelivered. With one GOP source who worked on the investigation telling CNN that people wished Comer had reined in his rhetoric. In fact, here's an example of this from last July.
This is one of the biggest crimes that I've ever studied with respect to American history. This is troubling. Every American should strongly oppose public corruption, and that's what this investigation is all about.
Okay, and a lot of media figures were really not pleased with the fact that Comer didn't seem to have the goods. And so here's a media compilation that kind of gives you a sense of what I'm referring to.
You have spoken with whistleblowers. You have spoken, you also spoke with an informant who gave you all of this information. Where is that informant today? Where are these whistleblowers?
Well, unfortunately, we can't track down the informant.
I know the Republicans said that the smoking gun were these financial records that you were able to subpoena and got your hands on. And your party, the Republican investigators, say that that's proof of influence peddling by Hunter and James. But that's just your suggestion. You don't actually have any facts to that point. You've got some circumstantial evidence of all those names. The one person who didn't profit is there's no evidence that Joe Biden did anything illegally.
And we're gonna move forward with Plan B.
Congressman, what's Plan B?
Well, stay tuned, Maria. You'll be the first person that'll know, I can assure you.
What specific action did he take as a public official, an elected public official,
well,
that led to those businesses
benefit?
If you have that evidence, present
it. Calm down, it's okay. No, okay. All the angry liberals, they'll be fine. All right, listen.
I mean, there were a lot of people involved in that media compilation that did not include angry liberals. A lot of conservatives asking for Comer to provide the goods, which he failed to do. And now he's claiming, I've got so much in terms of goods, I don't know what to do with it, so I'm just gonna drop the case. Okay, all right.
I mean, it's such a hilarious joke.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you.
First of all, did you guys notice? This is one of the biggest crimes I've ever seen. And then today, it's like avoiding taxes, maybe perjury. By the way, avoiding taxes, it's funny that you brought that up. What is the one bill that the Republicans have proposed? They've done 100 hearings on Hunter Biden, his laptop and his penis, right? But what is the bill they actually proposed that is policy? To cut IRS agents who are investigating tax avoidance by the rich. Now you're worried about tax avoidance. It was your number one priority to make sure that your donors and all the rich people in this country could avoid taxes. And now you think it's the biggest crime in the country? I mean, come on, man. Politicians are the biggest liars in the world. But my last question is, and I don't know the answer to this. Like, I know the answer when it comes to Maria Bartiromo. She's in cuckoo land.
She right? has seemed to have lost her mind.
She has crazy eyes. Okay, let's just keep it real. Like, she's like, James Comer, where's evidence? Right? Because she really believes it. And I, ironically, I'm actually like complimenting her. I don't think she's lying to you. I think she really.
She seems to believe it.
Yeah, yeah, she's genuinely like surprised. I thought this was gonna be the biggest crime, James. Where's the evidence? And she's like, she thinks James Comer's hiding it from her. Okay, but for the rest of them, Bowling and all the GOP politicians that leaked to Senate, did you guys really think he had evidence? Come on.
You know, the final thing I'll say about this is it doesn't help Comer that he looks like a deer caught in the headlights in every interview, right? Like he always says, are they asking me questions about this investigation?
Totally, like, Anna.
It's hilarious.
Such a great point. Because I was trying to figure out what it is. Because like, brother, if you're gonna come on and you know they're gonna ask you, hey brother, where's the evidence, right? You should have something prepared. So that every time they ask you, you're not like, evidence. Oh, it's gonna be plan H. Okay, I am prepared. I have done a lot of preparation H. And I will get that to you forthright.
It's so true.
How did you not prepare for that question?
Oh, it's so good. It's so good.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.